inquiry. We had a lot of mini inquiries in our investigation, like which diameter formula to use, which formula, the open-ended or the closed-ended pipe would work out, and obviously with scale sounds better. For our Ode to Joy inquiry investigation lab, we looked at air harmonics, because everything related to a pipe and sound comes under air harmonics and not string harmonics. When we are looking at air harmonics, there's two kinds. There's the open-ended pipe, where the pipe is open from both ends, and then there's the closed-ended, where when we're hitting the pipe, it's closed from one side. To figure out which formula to use, we first thought we'd use the closed-ended formula, because when we're hitting it, that's when we're checking our note. But soon after, we realized that we should be using the open-ended, and I'll talk more about this in our errors. We'll be looking at the fundamental frequency, because we only want when n equals 1, because we just want one standing wave. So the first thing we have to do after determining which formula to use was to find out L, because we have to cut our pipes to make our instrument. And to find L, we use the F equals mv upon 2L formula, as discussed before, and figured out that L is equal to V upon 2F. As we already discussed, L is equal to V by 2F. So let me ask you this question. What values do we use for V and F? We did some research and found out that the equation for speed is 331.5 plus 0.6 t in Celsius, and got that this is our speed that we are supposed to use. Next, let's move on to frequency. For frequency of each note, we did exactly what we were supposed to do in this inquiry lab. Researched. As we go an octave higher, from A3 to A4, the frequency doubles, and then when we go from A4 to A5, surprise, surprise, the frequency doubles again. And these were all the notes we used in Ode to Joy, and there's two notes that occur twice, there's the B2 and the B3, and then there's the C3 and the C4. As we go from B2 and to B3, we go an octave higher, and guess what happens to the frequency again? It doubles! Because the pipes were cylindrical in shape, we also had to take the diameter into consideration and figure out how the diameter would affect the L value. So we did the exact same thing we were supposed to always do in this inquiry, and we researched. And we figured out three ways on the internet of how the diameter would affect the L value. And we sort of conducted a mini inquiry lab in this inquiry lab. We took a note, A3, and we figured out how three different formulas would affect our length. We also took a control group, and our control group was V divided by 2F. And these were the four values we got. And we cut our pipes with these four values. And after cutting the pipes, we hit all four of these pipes and had a frequency detector on, and whichever one would give us the value of A3 or 220 Hertz, we take that as our group. So now we talk about the most amazing thing we can ever talk about in an experiment, the errors and what problems we faced. As mentioned before, we were confused about which formula to use, because theoretically speaking, we should be using this formula because the pipe becomes a closed-ended pipe when we hit it. But when our frequency detector reads its readings, it gets this, which reads it through this formula. So when we are using this formula, we keep on getting the frequencies wrong. So while we were conducting our mini experiment, we found out that it's better to use this formula than that one, because when the frequency detector is reading our results, it is reading it as if it's an open-ended pipe. That's why this formula works much better. Because of the confusion between the two formulas, and we figured, we